Hi, my name is Jessica Martinez, and today we're going to be talking about arrays. So today we're going to be solving an array problem. A couple of them, actually. We're going to use an array to store someone's grocery list and output their whole list, and we're going to use an array to store someone's grades and output their GPA. They're both basically the same concept. We're just going to be changing the... We're going to do one, and then we're going to be changing the values for the other one. Some important things to remember are that arrays have a set number of items inside. So if you say your arrays have 5 items inside, you can't store 6. It's gonna say what it says here, segmentation fault. Possibly it'll just throw you an error and exit out of the code. The way to declare an array is you start with the data type, then you any data type, you can say string, int, double, character, and then you go with the array name. In this case, we're gonna go with grocery list, and then we have to use the brackets and say array size inside. Something really important to remember is that in order to get the size of an array, you have to do size of the name of the array, which is gonna be grocery list, and then divide that by the size of the first item at our list. Right, so let's get started. So first, and you're going to be hearing my keyboard a bit, and I apologize for that. So first, we're going to ask the user. So since we don't know how long our list is going to be, we're going to first declare an integer variable that's the user input. And we're going to prompt, the user. We're going to be like, enter the number of items on your list, right? And we're gonna inline sin the user input. Now what this does is that it just asks the user, hey, like how many items on your list, right? And then they're gonna tell us, and it's gonna be stored in user input. And now that we know the size of the array, we're gonna declare the array. We're gonna say it's a string array. The name is going to be grocery list. And we're going to, the size of it, it's going to be whatever the user says. So use our variable, user input. Now since we already declared the array, we want to fill it up. We're going to use a for loop. Oops, my bad. And we're going to say int I equals 0. You can use whatever variable you want. I usually go with I. And then, like I said before, we're going to be using this to get the size of the array. I'm just going to copy and paste it for convenience. So the size of the array name is going to be grocery list divided by size of grocery less than 0, and here it's going to be, well, I is less than all of this, and then we're going to make it iterate. I'm going to make this a little bit to this side, so you can see the whole code, and then inside of the loop we're going to have we're going to prompt the user, we're going to say enter the item in your list and line numbers cn. We're going to put it directly into the array, so we're going to cn grocery list at I. And I think this should work, I think. Unless there's a mistake, let me run it just to check. Let's see, there's something. I think I have double brackets here. Alright, so enter the number of items on your list. I should have 2. Enter the item on your list. I don't know, I'm gonna have apple and an orange. Oops. Alright, so it looks like it's working. So now what we want to do, we want to output, we're going to loop it again. We're just going to copy and paste this whole thing for convenience. Sorry about that. And since we already know that the loop goes through the whole, it loops the number of items in the array, so we're just gonna see out what's in the array. So I think this should work. I'm gonna go with an M line here, just for convenience, let's say. Let's see what the error is. There's something expected. Let me just look at it. Oh. I had a CN and I changed it. My bad. So now enter the number of items on your list. Let's say I have 3 items. Now I'm gonna buy a soda. I'm gonna have a party, I'm gonna buy a soda. Some chips, I don't know, plates. Alright, and I output soda, chips, and plates, so that would be working properly. Now, let's take a look at our second problem. It says, use an array to store someone's grades and output their GPA. It's basically the same concept. I'm just gonna work through it really fast. So, we're gonna use the same int user input. So we're gonna see out, enter the number classes you have, the end line here, and then we should have sin. Again, we're just gonna recycle the variable, because why not? Now we're gonna go with, since it doesn't give us letter grades, we're gonna go with char grades. User input. Now we're gonna go with 4. We're just gonna use this. I'm just gonna change the value of, instead of grocery list, we're gonna have grades. Enter the grade of the class. And that should go into grades I. And that should fill up our array. And now what we can do is we're gonna loop through it again. We're gonna loop through all of it. So I'm just gonna copy and paste this. For int I equals blah, blah. Okay. So now, all right. So let's make a variable called total outside. I'm just gonna do it up top because it just makes it easier. Int total. And then we're gonna go with here, like I said. We're gonna start a couple of if statements. So if grades at I equal A, then we're gonna have total plus equals 4. And actually, I'm gonna make total equal 0 here, just for common practice. Because then we can end up with a garbage number and it's gonna mess up our whole calculations. And I'm just gonna copy and paste this several times. I'm just gonna be changing the letter from A to B. Oh, and then I have to write it like that, right? Because it's a letter. If it's a B, it should be a 3. If it's a C, it should be a 2. And let me copy and paste it one more time. If it's a D, it should be a 1, right? And then we're just gonna see out we're gonna say double and we're gonna go with total divided by this right here, which is the size of our array. Oops. We could also use user input here, but I'm just gonna go with this. Alright, let's try it out. Let's start with the first one. We already know that it works, but let's go with apple and orange. Alright, so now enter the number of classes I have. Let's say I have 3 classes. They're in my class. I have an A. Let's say I have straight A's. So there you go, it should output a 4. I'm not sure if it will. Let's see, enter the number. I didn't plan for this. Doesn't matter. Enter the number. Let's say I have 3 classes now. I have an A, a B, and an A. So there you go, you can see that it also, since I use this, it outputs this as a double. So that's basically it. That's basically how you would solve a problem including arrays. Thank you.